I said it before, be inventive in hospitality. And from the material I've given you this morning, there is one challenge here to you with a two-pronged approach. The challenge is to exercise hospitality toward people you don't know so well. People you hardly know. This is, firstly, so that you can be part of God's plan to connect unsaved people to Jesus, who in Luke 5 are called outsiders, and in Luke 15 they're called the lost. But it is also that you can, so you can be part of God's plan to connect the saved to each other, and more deeply to Jesus. Hebrews 13:2 in GWT, don't forget to show hospitality to believers you don't know. Don't forget to do that. Every Sunday someone new shows up here. Every Sunday, I don't know when the last time was that a new person didn't show up. They always do. And so you have what an opportunity! Even if you do the Lara thing, you know. Are you saved? Well, yes, but I'm a backslider. Good. You need a soap journal. That's just a coffee. You wait till you see it with over a meal. So that's the first way, coffee and tea, or sometimes soup after the service. Share with that person. Find them. Don't grab, oh, I'm going back to the same old people I always know because I'm safe there. Take a risk, they won't bite. They never had me anyway. Sorry, I don't think they will you. Second way, take a risk and invite someone home to lunch. That's the whole idea of Hospitality Sunday on the 22nd of August. Invite someone home. Here we go. Romans 12:11 in the Message. Be what? Inventive in hospitality. I wonder what you're going to do if you're inventive. See, there's all sorts of things. You think, oh man, got to cook the roast. He said roast lamb. No, I didn't say anything. That's just what they did. And roast beef. You might get fish and chips. You might have someone over for breakfast. There's an idea. There's some connected groups ought to do that. I know one that does that. I know a couple that do that. You might say, well, I don't want to run my place at lunchtime. I'll have my afternoon tea. Good. Good. If you have any scones and jam and cream, invite me. I'm there too. You might say, no, I want to do morning tea Saturday. That's what I would do. So I don't want them in my house. I know someone else here like us right now. We put our lounge suite on eBay because we're moving house in a couple of months' time. They came around and someone bought it on eBay, my lounge suite, and they saw our dining suite, and they took a fancy to that, so I sold that too. Now I got four grandsons in the house, so we got the old trestle out of the garage. So we probably won't have any grandsons. But see, there's other ways. You know, at your house. Right. At a restaurant. Take someone out to a restaurant. Picnic in the park. How about that? Dinner, breakfast, lunch. Afternoon tea, morning tea, just coffee. That's what we're doing, going out for coffee and cake, that's it. Have two or three families over. Have only one over. Have the single people over. Have the married couples over. You cook everything. You say, I'm having three couples over, three families. I'm going to do this, would you bring that? Yeah. You say, we're just having fish and chips. So we have a Vegemite sandwiches. Nobody's coming. You figure it out. Be inventive. I just wonder what you will do. It's just don't get locked in. It says be inventive. Just invite someone over. You might have angels come. You might have angels come over. Now say it with me as we get ready to wrap it up. The meal is always on about more than food and drink. Over a meal, Jenny. Some people have done the right thing and taken that big step forward. Over a meal, some people have found Christ. Over a coffee, some people have found a sojourn hall. Over a meal, over morning tea. Every time out here, I get to talk to someone about some issue. I'm going to talk to someone this morning. I know it already. Because I'm lining this one up. Someone wants to, every time, over a coffee. People just feel relaxed over the coffee. I've got to sit down for the coffee and I want to talk to you about this issue, that issue. And they're moving closer to Jesus. Over a meal. I just wonder. Strategic questions over morning tea. Someone says, well, why have we got to do all this coffee and soup and stuff? Because people open up. Jesus did it. I want to do whatever it was that Jesus did. And this is what I want to say to you now, if we wrap this up. You don't have to wait for coffee, tea, biscuits, scones, meal, fish and chips, Vegemite sandwich, anything, in order to surrender your life to Christ.
Yes. now is the moment. Don't wait for the meal.
Use the meal.
But don't wait for the meal. Father in heaven, I thank you for your word. Lord Jesus Christ, thank you for the model that you've set us. We want to use your model. Lord, you've said be inventive in hospitality and stir up the creative juices in every individual here in the house this morning, Father. I know some folk, Father, we think, I just can't do the 22nd. Same weekend, there's so many other things wrong. Same weekend as the voting, same weekend as the 40-hour famine, same weekend as the men's conference. Lord, give them that creativity to do it on another weekend. Father, we have so much on about the inventiveness in hospitality itself, but in our endeavours to connect with you, to be your ambassadors, your instruments, in enabling other people to connect to you. Father, take us this morning. Lead us to your throne. Lead us close to you, Lord Jesus. Help us to step out. So coming home, Lord God. Coming home now. In Jesus' name. And let's stand for it. Use this song as a prayer this morning. Would you come home closer to God than you've ever been before? If you've never really said, you know, decisively, I surrender to you, Lord Jesus, do that this morning. Would you not? Don't put him off. If you've done that and you've strayed away because of people or circumstances, whatever, your own stuff going on, come on back this morning as close as you can. If you're needing prayer this morning, come on for that prayer this morning. I'm going to invite you to stand out front. If you're searching for God, if you want to say yes to Jesus, if you want to say, hey, I want to get it all back together how it should be, Jesus, this one, come and stand in front. If you're needing prayer for any of these issues or anything in your life, come and stand in the front. I'll have folk who will pray with you and encourage you this morning in Jesus' name. Let's sing together. You step out to hear the voice of God.
Direction, give direction, Father. Where there needs to be a power of the Holy Spirit.
stall. Check out the information desk. Maybe something you wish to sign up for. Tea and coffee around the rear of the building. Hey, there's a great opportunity. Invite someone around for a coffee. And by the way, cover.